Oh, welcome to my place. I've had so many requests from you out there wanting to know how to make milk paint. For those of you who don't know what milk paint is, it's like one of the oldest known paints to man. It's really strong and it's really robust, and once it hits a wooden surface or a porous surface, it won't go anywhere. Now, Michelangelo used this type of paint to do the Sistine Chapel, and when you look into there and the beautiful muted shades, it's absolutely fantastic. And I just love this visual here. They're really soft and muted, beautiful, beautiful paints. Now, for those of you knowing about Vesuvius, as they've unearthed some of the ruins and all those beautiful frescoes that you can now see, go online and have a look. They were all used using the same kind of product. It's really great on things like wood or onto plaster and terracotta. Now, it's really easy to make. All you need is I use full cream milk powder, and you also need some lime. Now, you have to be really good about keeping records and measuring everything properly when you do this. Now, where's my container? Now, the other thing is, because we're using lime and we're also using milk powder, it's best to wear a mask, but for this purpose, I'll just stand back. But anyway, as I said, everything's got to be measured properly and perfectly, and keep a note. It's just like making a cake. If you want it to be right every time, you've got to make sure that you keep meticulous records. So that's 12 of milk powder goes into there, and I'll put that out of the way. The next thing is the one of lime, and you can get this from your garden center, good old everyday lime. The thing about this is sometimes it's got lumps in it, so just be very careful that there aren't any big stony horrible bits when you're doing it. Now, the next thing that I like to do, and I'll just give that a wipe, keep everything dry at this stage, give that a little bit of a mix in like so. And what you're going to do is you need to mix this to the consistency of pancakes. Right, little bit of water can go into there, and just add a little bit, don't add too much. It's like, for those who know making scones or biscuits or whatever you call them in whatever area of the world that you come from, if you add too much milk there or buttermilk there, it's just going to go all sort of sloppy and luggy. So just give that a good stir like so, and then allow that to rest for a couple of hours until hopefully it's come to that lovely consistency like I've got there. Right, from there, the next thing to do is clearing up as I go, because I want to be nice and tidy. The next thing is to get your milk out and lime after it's been sitting, and then pour it into a little bit of muslin or some cheesecloth over a sieve, and just let that just all sort of like go through the muslin or your cheesecloth right through into the sieve like so. Now, you should really be wearing gloves, but never mind, I'm not. Now, I'll show you why I've done that. See that there? That cluggy stuff down there would be not very nice on your surface. Right, from there, I'll just dump that, and I'll just wash my hands while I'm here. Now, the other thing is, as I said, to make sure that you do wear gloves, because we're working with lime. Right, from there, that is your basic recipe. When I come back, I'm going to show you how to colour it up, because there's lots of wonderful things that you can achieve. I will see you another day. Thanks for watching.